Echo. Today we're going to do a quick tutorial on how to use Amazon Alexa's new beta developer for creating multi-part intents. Now Amazon has some tutorials on their website that I'll link in the description, but those tutorials are broad overviews and they don't capture some of the smaller pieces that developers spend a lot of time trying to troubleshoot. A quick overview, I'm going to open up Amazon Alexa's skill developer and create a multi-part intent. And then I'm going to switch over to Amazon's Lambda functions. The skill that I'm going to develop today is going to be a fun clue-style game with a multi-part input including a person, a place, and a weapon. Then Alexa is going to respond with a somewhat witty, somewhat tragic response.
Seriously, this is a kid's game? I'll take out John in the ballroom with the sword.
A quick note, if I do miss anything, feel free to note it in the comments below, and I'll try and update the description to include it. We're going to start at developers.amazon.com. Then we're going to sign in. Click on Alexa. Next click Alexa Skill Kit. We're going to add new skill. Name it Hitman 2. Set the invocation name. And save. Next we'll head to the interaction model. We'll launch the skill beta builder. And add an intent. We're going to name our intent Hit Intent. Create intent. Activating the skill would be something along the lines of, Alexa, start Hitman. And then what might you say? Maybe, I've created the variables target name, room name, and weapon name. Now I can go to the side and make them each required. Next it's important to define what they are. Target name is just going to be a first name. Next is room name. Amazon doesn't have a predefined list of rooms, so I'll create my own variable. Finally, weapons. Once again, Amazon doesn't have a list of weapons, so I'll have to create my own. To edit these slot types, come to the left side, click on Rooms List, and then just start adding rooms. It's a good list. Now I'll edit weapons list. If you check out my weapons list, it's pretty incomplete. But Alexa still understands what my intent is, so the weapon doesn't necessarily have to be on the list. With the new beta developer, you can have a multi-part intent. We're requiring target name, room name, and weapon name. If you don't answer the initial target name when you invoke the skill, Alexa will ask a follow-up question in order to get the target name. And then some sample responses. It might just be target name. Or his name is. Now that that's satisfied, we'll move on to room name. That's good. Same with weapon. I'm just going to humor the program by adding some more sample intents. We're good. Next, we're going to build the model. It says that it takes between 2 to 5 minutes. I found it usually takes about a minute. Our model is built. We're going to save the model. Interaction model was saved. Now we're going to move to some of the more specifics. Next thing is we're going to link to an Amazon Lambda function. Use the North American server. We haven't made our function yet. We'll do that now. Sign into the console. I've used Lambda recently, but you can search for Lambda. We'll create a new Lambda function. Blank function. Alexa Skill Kit. In the upper right hand corner, it says North Virginia. If it doesn't say North Virginia, set it to North Virginia. That's the only location that will execute the Alexa skill kit. We're going to set the name of our function to Hitman skill. Description. And then our runtime will be node. Delete this code. Now I actually have some example code that I'm going to pull up from GitHub. I'm going to come over to Amazon Lambda, copy in that code. We're going to have to set an existing role. I'm going to use Lambda Basic Execution. If you don't have Lambda Basic Execution, you can create a role, new role, create a custom role, and then name it Lambda Basic Execution. You can also hop into the advanced settings where you can set the amount of memory that your function will use. This function won't use a lot of memory, but if you have a more complex function, you might want to up that. You can also up the amount of time you let it execute for before it times out. A warning though, you're not charged by the amount of time you allocate, but you're charged by the amount of memory that you allocate. So if you allocate a large amount that's not needed, you still get charged for having used that whole amount of memory. We'll hit next. Review your skill, name, description, node runtime, Lambda basic execution. This is where you see the time and memory you've allocated. We're going to hit create. Next, we're going to copy this ID, head back over to our Alexa skill developer, paste it into North America, hit next. It'll save that. Now we're ready to test. If you don't have testing enabled, just enable it. And then you can scroll down to the bottom and enter sample utterances. The sample utterances really don't work for the multi-part inputs. If you type out the whole sentence, though, it does work. Echo. Open Hitman game.
Who would you like me to whack?
Take out Caleb in the ballroom with the gun.
There was a problem with the requested skills response.
Naturally, I'm running into some errors. I'm going to copy the Lambda request. Head over to Lambda. Go to Actions. Configure Test Event. Paste it in. Save and test. Review the output. And I have no idea what's wrong. I figured out what's wrong. When I created my new variables, I named them target name, room name, and weapon name, whereas before I had target name, target location, and weapon name. So I'm on line 119. I'm going to change target location to room name. And I'm going to do the same thing to this target location and to this target location. That should be enough. Control S. Echo. Open Hitman game.
Who would you like me to whack?
Take out Caleb in the ballroom with the knife.
I'm putting on my game face. I'll take out Caleb in the ballroom with the knife.
I'm pretty sure these multi-part inputs don't work with the test events. It works when I talk to my Echo, but it doesn't work when I put it into the test event or in the Amazon's sample utterances. I get a feedback of nothing. However, if I say something like, Echo, open the Hitman game.
Who would you like me to whack?
Take out John.
In what room?
The ballroom.
What weapon would you suggest?
The sword.
Seriously, this is a kid's game? I'll take out John in the ballroom with the sword.
That works. But if I paste it into the sample utterances, it doesn't. So, for that reason, we're going to move forward. Heading back to Lambda management, the last thing I want to jump through quickly is the code. This is code that I got from the sample Amazon developer. However, I couldn't find an explanation for most of it. The code that I used is a sample from the Alexa travel skill, but it's the version that doesn't need the SDK. If you wanted to use the SDK, you could download the in-text and JSON package, but you'd have to compile it using Node. You then have to zip it up and upload the file to Lambda Management each time using upload zip. This is far more time consuming for someone like me who's just tinkering, changing little things, and troubleshooting. However, if you do have a larger project that does need some of the functions that are available in that larger skill kit, I'd recommend using it. On line 23, there's a function that builds the responses. I haven't edited those at all. Then on line 83, there's the welcome response. I did edit the words that it will say. Who would you like me to whack? What weapon do you think I should use? Changing it up a little. Next, there's the function on line 99 that I have execute when the hit intent is called, that I call take out a hit. This function was pretty much built. The things that I did edit was the speech output random phrase, which can be found on line 15. I have an array of a few different funny lines that she can start with before she gives you the final response. Going back down, the important thing to note are the target name. These slots that we've defined as variables are stored in request.intents.slots.variablename.value. So if you have multiple slots, you can retrieve them by simply using this format and changing the name of the variable name and storing it to a variable. I then have my speech output, which I've edited, which is just a string that I've interjected these different variables into. Finally, there's the callback function. There's some other functions along here, including handle session end request. That's a pre-built, you can edit it. I'm going to edit mine now for this skill. Now, this is something that I find very interesting, but don't claim to quite understand. On line 137, there's a function called Delegate Slot Collection. I'm fairly certain this is a function that is used for these multi-part inputs that decides whether or not all the slots are filled, and if not, it sends it back. It was my understanding when I started with the multi-part inputs that that was taken care of on the front end before calling the Lambda function. After reading through this example, I'm pretty sure that's not the case. I'm pretty sure that the function does execute, but this is a feature built to see if all the slots are there. I don't quite understand it, but it's something that you should definitely look through if you want to learn more about multi-part intents. The last section, events. On session start, specific things are done. On launch, specific things are done. The one that you as a developer probably have the most interest in is on intent. If you come down, there's a list of if, else ifs, where you can take a specific intent name like plan my trip or hit intent, and you can have it execute a specific function. That function, takeOutHit, is the function that we saw above on line 99. There's one last thing you can do in the main handler around line 250. That would be uncomment this block of code and set a specific Amazon skill that can execute this Lambda function. Otherwise, anyone with your Amazon Lambda function ID can put it into their Alexa function and have it execute. You get that code up here in the Hitman skill up top. So let's test it. Echo. Open Hitman game.
Who would you like me to whack?
Take out John.
Where?
On the porch.
What shall I use?
A knife.
Seriously, this is a kid's game? I'll take out John in the poor with a knife.
Obviously it doesn't know how to say porch. But you can tell it executed, and it will only execute for my app. Well, that's it. I hope you learned something from this tutorial. If you did, feel free to like this video. If I did miss something, feel free to comment below. I'll try and add it to the description. Feel free to check out any of my other videos on my channel. Hopefully there will be more tutorials to come. If you have any suggestions on things that you're finding it hard to understand with the Amazon Echo, feel free to comment those below, and I'll see if it's worthy of making a video or if I can point you in the direction of some other resource on the internet.